back. My name is Wenani. Actually, you can see I'm using TeklaTedds. So, you know, currently there are so many softwares out there like CAD and BIM, and you may be confused like, what is TeDS? Why should I use it, or what does it do? So TeDS is majorly a calculation engine. By calculation engine, I mean all computations in civil engineering, you can be able to carry them using TeklaTedds. So today I want us to go through cut and fill to compute the cut and fill volumes. So the first thing I said, once you start your software, you come to new document, and if you are interested in this software, please, you can email me. My email is in the description. You can email me and request for it, and I'll send to you a download link so that you can be able to get it. So you can see all of these analysis, beams, columns, composite, concrete, all of these things can be calculated. Like Tekla helps you to calculate all this, but you are supposed to be able to have some knowledge of how to do it. If you don't know how to do it, then probably you will have some problems. So we go to earthworks if you want to carry out the cut and fill volumes. Of course, that's earthworks in roads. Then we want to cut and fill. We're not going to store slope stability. So I click on cut and fill. And as you can see, so there was a place I was computing the cut and fill volume for a road, and we're using AutoCAD in Civil 3D. So we had the proposed level, and then we had data which was showing the existing level. So you are supposed to input, once you input that data, you are then hatching. Once you hatch, you check the properties of that hatch, then you will be able to know the area and the volume of where you want to fill or you want to cut. But in Tekla, you can be able to do it in a different way. So there are many ways. So of course, there's an example here, and also this is a tutorial. It will teach you how to do it, and also an example, you can go through it. But if you want to calculate, you click on the cut and fill, this one, cut and fill, you double click on it. So once you double click on it, of course this depends on the speed of your machine, and it's a bit slow, so it will take some time. So you get something like this. If you have a template, you can import your template, you can click here and enter your templates, or you can just add a section, you click add a section, then you have your 0.00, and the offset. So I'm assuming you have done maybe cut and fill before before for a road, so you know how it goes. So you normally have the level on this side, and then you have the offset from the center line. This is the center line, so you can do it. So for me, the method that I want to show you is using, I enter all the data that I need for the existing and the proposed, and then I import and do the calculation. Just click on calculation. So to do that, we need to come up with if you can read here, you'll be able to see a text file. So you need to come up with a text file. So for that, I can go to Notepad, and I will start with existing. So you type existing, then underscore, then I type, so you want to show like it is which section. So we are beginning with section one, so I open bracket, I say section one, then I close it, then is equals to, then this. So this is not programming, this is just something simple. Do you want to give the programmers like a certain command, but it's not programming. So I'm beginning with the offset from the center line, like as you can see here from here. So maybe I'm drawing the existing line. I want to tell it, maybe I want you to begin from negative 5.0 or negative 4, this side like that. But of course, if you have a road, you already have this information, because the surveyors they normally collected from the field. So I can begin by saying negative like 5.000 meters. So you have to specify the units, then I press comma, then I enter the level for that, for the elevation, I mean for that part, for that section. Let me say it is 100.350 meters. Then like that, then I so that will be the first point. Like this will give me the first point. Then I go to the next point. For the next point, I also want to, I can enter like negative 4.00 meters, like that. You press comma after something, then you enter the level for that. Let me say 100.85. So I'm just guessing for now. Then I can continue, maybe negative 3.00 meters. Then maybe I say the level is 100 point, let me assume that to be 0.400 meters. So make sure you enter the units. Then let me say I have 0.000 meters. The level for that, let me put it at 100.450 meters. Then of course now I go to the right side, which will be positive, so it can be like positive 2.000 meters, like that. Then I enter the level. So these things are just simple. Enter the level, so for now I'm just guessing, that's fine. So I can continue like that to the last point. Then when I finish, I press, you close your command. Then I come to proposed. I repeat the same thing. So this is proposed for section 1 is equals then I can enter the values again. So you will have the values for the proposed, because the surveyors have provided you with the values. So after you have done, you close. After you have entered the values, not the full stops, you close. Then when you go to the second one, you go to, again it will be existing, but this time it will be number 2, because that's section 2. So existing 2 is equals to, then you enter the values and again you go to proposed 2, like that, and you repeat. So there is one that I already have, so I just want to import that one, and you can see. So I click on import, export this one, then I come here and choose what I want. So let me go with this one, text, and I click open. So if you have made any error, it will be able to show you. Then I click import. So if you have any error, you'll be able to see here. Then you can go and correct. Then I have to apply, right now I've not applied the chain edge. So you know the chain edge mostly 0.0 plus something, but in this case you just start from 0 and to increase, there is no 0 plus something. So I begin from 0. Then the section interval, I want it to be, let me say 10 meters. Well, let me put 20 meters. Then I click apply. So once I apply, you can see this one is here, 0.00, this and 20 meters. So if I have more sections, you'll be able to see them, the information. Then I just click on calculate. This one, just say okay. And you wait. Of course this depends with the speed of your machine. So it is done. So I click OK. And you can see this is how my section looks like. So this, the blue one, the proposed, then the other one is the existing. So I can export this to a PDF, of which by just clicking finish. Also you are able, so Also in this case, there is something that you add on. I think it's on calculation. There is this factor called shrinkage factor, which depends on the type of soil at a certain location. But you are provided with them. You just have to choose like one. So you are provided with them. So for now, I've just chosen a default of one. But you can choose here the shrinkage factor according to the type of the soil that you're using. So, okay, so this one is okay. So I just click finish. And of course, again, depends on the speed of your machine. So this one, you can export it to Word or to PDF. So if you have several sections, you'll be able to see all of them, the information. You can see the volume, this depending on the shrinkage factor and that, and also the information for each drainage, cut area, fill area, all that information is provided. So you should try out this software. It's actually cool, and it will be able to help you with so many things. So next time we will try out maybe the design of a sewer system or maybe we can also try out to carry out a calculation on beams or analysis of beams and columns and all that. Then later on, I said we'll try to draw them in Tekla Structural, where you'll be able to obtain actually automatically the details with the number of beams and all that, the number of bars, because you know Tekla Structural is BIM software, building information modeling, so you normally draw stuff in a scale of 1:1. So if you are drawing something in scale of 1:1, it means you can be able to, it will be able to, you'll be able to carry out estimations easily, because what you are drawing something as built, not using any scale. So see you next time. Please subscribe so that, please subscribe. Thank you. I'll appreciate.